Morning, guys. Thank you for joining me early this morning at about 4:12 a.m. local time. There was a magnitude 3.9 earthquake near Skokomish, Washington. So far, 70 people have reported feeling this earthquake. It was along the Olympia fault, and it was felt over a fairly wide area. Here you can see Washington and the Seattle area. Not a lot of research has been done for the Olympia fault. In fact, many geologists will argue that it's a fault at all, but a slab that's either subducting or rising up. There is no surface evidence of this fault, but there is evidence of the fault down here by the Bud Inlet. They did core samples, I believe, and discovered the fault at the mouth of the inlet for Bud. This basin is basically a lot of sediment deposits. So if there is a large earthquake, it would cause a lot of damage. Now, that scenario was based on a very shallow earthquake, but this one was very deep. This earthquake was about 30 miles in depth, or 28.6 kilometers. Questions about is the slab, if that's the case for this fault zone, either subsiding or rising up. Well, this moment tensor ball indicates that it rose up and we got spreading. I found a paper about a scenario. It's for a magnitude 5.7 earthquake along the Olympia fault. I'll give you a link to this. It'll be down below in the more information box below this video. Now, their scenario for this 5.7 earthquake is based on a shallow crustal earthquake. It talks about how this area is basically sediments and tend to have high liquefaction potential. The potential for the Puget Sound is likely. If the floor of that area ruptures, it would be a local tsunami. And they have found evidence of past tsunamis in the Puget Sound area. If the Olympia Fault had a shallow earthquake of a magnitude 5.7, it would impact, they feel, 5 counties. Total injuries would be about 94 people. Total number of buildings with extensive damage would be over 388. Total number of buildings completely damaged, destroyed, would be 29. Today, that effect would probably be much greater because this paper is from 2013. It's now 2021. USGS does not have a rupture distance for this fault zone. None whatsoever. There would be only two reasons for that. One, there's controversy that this is in fact a fault. They do have evidence of it that they seem to be ignoring, or the fact that the moment tensor ball shows it was uplift. If in fact this is a fault zone, it probably interacts or connects with the Tacoma fault zone, which is off over here on the right. And as you know, any earthquake has a chance of triggering an earthquake on another fault zone, adjoining fault zone. And as you know, any earthquake has a 20% chance of being a foreshock for a much larger earthquake. And of late, we have seen a lot of earthquakes in very unusual and diverse places. USGS gives this earthquake an intensity level of 4, which means it's light. So guys, how many of you felt this earthquake? If you did feel it, how long did it last? Did you have anything fall over or any slight damage from this earthquake? Please put that information down below. Thank you for watching. Always be prepared for a disaster. I certainly hope you are. Yeah, being an area of sediment, if you have a large earthquake, many people and property, it would be devastating. Please stay safe, and I'll talk to you later. God bless y'all.